Nestled in the heart of the Nevada desert, Area 51 has captivated the world's imagination with its veil of secrecy and mysterious activities. From alien sightings to government cover-ups, the base has been the subject of countless conspiracy theories. Yet few know the actual facts about its purpose and operations. However, the history of the U-2 reconnaissance aircraft could offer some insight into the base's origins and the reason behind its association with unidentified flying objects. The history of Area 51 can be traced back to the Cold War, when the United States was in a race with the Soviet Union to develop advanced military technology. In the 1950s, the CIA began testing high-altitude reconnaissance aircraft that could fly over the Soviet Union undetected. These planes needed to be able to fly at extremely high altitudes, above the range of Soviet radar, and be equipped with cameras capable of taking high-resolution images of the ground below. To meet these requirements, the CIA turned to Lockheed's Skunk Works Division, a top-secret unit responsible for developing advanced aircraft. The Skunk Works team, led by the legendary aircraft designer Kelly Johnson, began work on what would become the U-2 spy plane. The U-2 was a remarkable piece of technology. It could fly at altitudes of over 21,300 meters, far above the range of Soviet radars. Its high-resolution cameras could capture images of the ground below with incredible detail, allowing the CIA to monitor Soviet military installations and nuclear sites from afar. The U-2 program was specifically designed with unique testing requirements that demanded a remote location far away from prying eyes. The CIA settled on a remote area of the Nevada desert known as Groom Lake as the ideal location for testing due to its dry climate and isolated location. To keep the project secret, the CIA gave the area the code name Area 51. Over the next decade, Area 51 became the center of the U-2 program. The base was expanded to include hangars, workshops, and living quarters for the personnel working on the project. In July 1955, the CIA began testing the U-2 reconnaissance aircraft. Almost immediately, reports began flooding in about unidentified flying object sightings in the area surrounding the testing site at Groom Lake. These sightings were often reported by commercial airline pilots who had never seen an aircraft fly at such high altitudes as the U-2. In the mid-1950s, commercial airlines flew at altitudes up to 6,000 meters, while known military aircraft could get to 12,000 meters. The U-2, flying at altitudes in excess of 20,000 meters, looked completely alien to those who had never seen an aircraft fly so high. It's no wonder that these sightings sparked rumors and conspiracy theories, even among experienced commercial pilots. Air Force officials were, of course, aware that most of the sightings were actually U-2 tests, but they were prohibited from disclosing this information to the public. Instead, they referred to them as natural phenomena or high-altitude weather research as explanations for the sightings of unidentified flying objects. Even after the U-2 program ended in the late 1950s, Area 51 remained a hub for top-secret military aircraft development in the following decades. Some of the most notable aircraft tested at the base include the A-12, a precursor to the iconic SR-71 Blackbird, the D-21 supersonic reconnaissance drone, and the F-117 Nighthawk stealth fighter. In the 21st century, Area 51 remains an active United States Air Force base for the development and testing of highly classified military technology. While much of what goes on at the base remains shrouded in secrecy, it's believed that the military is continuing to develop new and advanced aircraft, UAVs, and other technologies that help maintain the country's military superiority. If you want to see a full review on any of the platforms we mentioned, let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more content.